welcome to today's episode of the Money Sense Talk Show. My name is Alex Iyanacho. I'm the founder of Money Sense School. So today we are talking about the three things you need to look out for in the founders of a business that you want to invest in. So if you're an investor, you are looking at putting your money in a business, there are three things you need to look out for to be sure that the founders possess before you can go ahead and invest your money. These three skills are important because if they are not there, things could go wrong, right? Very quickly too. Things could go wrong very quickly. So you need to look at these three skills. Now, what are these three skills? Soft skills, right? You need to look at the founders of the business you want to invest in to see the kind of soft skills that they have. Are they good communicators? Because you need people who can really communicate their ideas clearly to the consumers, to the final users, and even to other investors and stakeholders to pass across his ideas to people and persuasively convince people to take action. It's very important, right? Soft skills also, like ability to negotiate, is a skill that you need to make sure that the founders of the business have. Also, things like emotional intelligence. How are they able to handle pressure? How are they able to handle different emotional dispositions? Because those are also important. We have a lot of people coming in with a lot of emotional issues. If the founders are not able to handle those things properly, it might bring a problem in the business. Okay, so soft skills are important. You must make sure that the founders or the founder of the business you want to invest in have these skills. The second one you need to look at is technical skills, right? You need to be able to be sure that the people you're trying to invest your money into their business have a fair understanding of the technical aspects of the business. Why this is important is because there might be time that, you know, urgent maintenance will be required, okay? There will be need for the person, the founder, to look at the MVP of a product and understand what it really looks like, whether it makes sense or not. There's a need for a founder to look at the product map of a particular product and be able to understand exactly what the user journey is, so that he can be able to explain and communicate it clearly to other investors, other stakeholders, and even the final user. Okay, so the technical skills of the founders, the ability to understand the technical aspect of their business is very important. Then thirdly is that you need to be sure that they have good business skills. This is important because running a business is a skill, okay? Entrepreneurship and being a business owner are two different things. Everybody is an entrepreneur. Entrepreneurship is just your ability to convert value from a place of low use to a place of high use, or your ability to move value from a place of low use to a place of high use, or a place of low profit to a place of more profit. That's what entrepreneurship is about, right? If a person can convert anything from a place of low utilization to a place of high, that's entrepreneurship. That is why the fact that you're an entrepreneur does not mean you must own your own business. It does not mean you must run your own business. You could work in someone else's organization and also be an entrepreneur in that organization. And that is why I always tell people that every entrepreneur doesn't have to be a business owner, but every business owner is an entrepreneur. That's very important for you to know. So before you invest your money in any business, you must be sure that the founders have good business skills, because it is the business skills that will make the money. It is the business skills that will bring the money. It is the business skills that will bring the profit that you will share at the end of the period. It is the business skills that will increase the valuation of the business. So if the people you're bringing in don't have these skills, then there is a problem somewhere. You need to bring people who have a very thorough understanding of what business is. They must be able to read a financial statement and understand it, right? They must be able to know the difference between revenue and profit. They must be able to understand that the fact that they are making money does not mean that they are making profit. They must be able to understand the difference between equity investing and debt financing. All these things are very key so that conversations can make sense. Because as an investor, you don't want to waste your time discussing with people who are not on the same page with you. It will slow you down. It will also disturb the vibes, right? You need people that before you say something, they understand. When you mention something, they are with you. It's very important, and that gives you some kind of vote of confidence in what you're doing with such a business. So learn to investigate these three things properly in the founders of any startup or any business that you're trying to put your money into, because if these things are not there, chances that the business will succeed is very slim, because these things are very important in making a business succeed, in making a business sustainable, and also in making a business profitable. And as an investor, what exactly are you looking for? You're looking for profits. You're looking for advance in equity. So if you don't eventually get an advance in equity, then it simply means that you've wasted your time. So to avoid that from happening, investigate to be sure that you're doing the right thing with the right people always. Share this video with someone that you love, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers.